Welcome to this tutorial on how to use the HealthMeasures scoring service. This tutorial will provide instructions for scoring PROMIS and Neuro-QoL short forms, including off-the-shelf short forms and short forms you've created by selecting specific PROMIS or Neuro-QoL items. If you'd rather read instructions than watch this video, download the user manual on the HealthMeasures scoring service homepage. Although there are scoring manuals for off-the-shelf short forms from PROMIS and Neuro-QoL, the HealthMeasures scoring service is the best option for calculating scores, as it's more accurate. This is because it is using the underlying item response theory parameters for each response and each question. This is known as response pattern scoring. It also does a better job at handling missing data, and unlike a manual, it can score custom short forms. To get started, you'll want to have your data in the correct format. This involves a few things. Start by going to the scoring service homepage and downloading the input template. You can see this is organized with one respondent represented by a pin. Each respondent has one row per assessment. There's one column for each item or question, and raw response scores are added for each item per respondent. An example of a completed template with short form data is included. It is important that you enter the correct item IDs and the correct response scores. This allows the scoring service to access that item's parameters to accurately calculate a score. I suggest you download the official PDF of your measure to verify you have the correct item IDs and response scores. The best place to find the official measure PDF is in the healthmeasures.net Search and View Measures tool. I will use the PROMIS Sleep Disturbance 8-item short form as an example. I'll fill out the search terms to find my measure. Here I found two different PROMIS sleep disturbance short forms with 8 items. I know that I used the 8A version, but if I wasn't sure, I could look at both and identify which one matched my data. I click on the name of the measure and now see a copy of the measure in English and Spanish. I'll download the English version. In this PDF, you can see on the left it includes the PROMIS item IDs, like sleep 109. Underneath each response is the corresponding response score. What you see in this short form is that sometimes a response of not at all gets a score of 5, but other times it gets assigned a score of 1. Make sure you have the right values in the response score columns in your data file. Here's my Excel file showing my response score data for 10 study participants who completed the PROMIS version 1 short form 8A for sleep disturbance. I have data from baseline, assessment 1, and a 1-month follow-up, assessment 2. I can include as many time points as I need in this file. I've also deleted the example data that was in the input template. In my study, not everyone answered all questions. I left the cells for items with missing data blank. You will also see that I have data for a second short form, a 5-item short form that I made by selecting items from the PROMIS Depression Item Bank. I can have additional short forms from other domains in the same file and will score them separately. Now I'm ready to score the sleep disturbance short form. The first time I use the scoring service, I need to register. I will complete this registration form and get a confirmation message. You will want to use a real email address because the scored files will be sent to you by email. I'm now in the scoring service. I'm scoring an off-the-shelf short form, so I will select existing short form profile. I'll use the drop list to find the sleep disturbance measure. Here are all of the measures that match my search criteria. I'll select the 8A short form. Now I'm prompted to select the calibration sample. This refers to the exact item parameters that I want to be used to calculate a score. There's always one calibration sample labeled default, and it's almost always the best one to use. You'll see other options in this list. Any item on the short form that has calibrations from a particular sample will result in that calibration sample showing up here. Now I'll need to provide a label for the scored output file. I'm going to call this Lung Cancer Study PROMIS Sleep Disturbance 8A to remind myself what data and measure I've used. I'll provide my email address where the scored output file will be sent. Again, I want to use an email that I can access. And finally, I can browse to find my input file. You can see I got an error message stating I have the wrong file format. I used Excel to make my input file, but I need to save it as a CSV file. I can do that in Excel by clicking Save As and selecting the CSV. I will upload the CSV version of this file, and now I have a confirmation message that my upload was successful. In my email, I received a message from help@assessmentcenter.net, and it includes 2 attachments. Let's look at those. The first is a CSV file with the label I provided, Lung Cancer Study PROMIS Sleep Disturbance 8A. The top part of the file shows my instrument and calibration sample selection. Below, I see the pins I provided, assessment number, and many columns of scoring information. For all analyses with PROMIS and Neuro-QoL measures, I want to use the T-score values along with the standard errors. A T-score has a mean of 50 and a standard deviation of 10. You can learn more about interpreting T-scores from PROMIS, Neuro-QoL, AskMe, and NIH Toolbox measures on the healthmeasures.net pages on score interpretation. You can also see this scored count column. It identifies how many items were used to calculate a score for this measure for this respondent. This shows me how many items a respondent skipped. You can see I still get a score even with skipped items. You'll recall I have an 8-item sleep disturbance short form and a 5-item custom depression short form in the file I uploaded. So this totals 13 items. If a respondent had no missing data in a given assessment, 8 items were used to calculate the sleep disturbance score. I can use this as a spot check to confirm all sleep items were used to produce a score. The second file labeled log is useful for checking that I constructed my input file correctly. Here I see the list of item IDs I provided along with an indication of whether or not it was used to calculate the final score. Here all 8 sleep items were in the selected short form and used to calculate a score. The 5 depression items were not in the sleep short form and not used to calculate a score, which is good. If I'd mistyped a sleep item ID, I would see a no in this column. You will want to check this file to confirm you've selected the right short form and entered item IDs correctly. Now I will score the custom depression short form. After logging in, I select custom short form. I use the search fields to find the parent item bank where I found my PROMIS depression items. In this case, the bank is PROMIS Bank version 1 depression. Again, I will use the default calibration sample, name the file, and enter an email address I can access. I'll upload the same CSV file that had my sleep short form. When I open the scored Excel file I received by email, I now see T-scores for my custom depression short form. The log file shows me that all 5 of the depression item IDs were in the parent item bank and all were used to calculate a final score. The sleep items were correctly ignored. This lets me know I set up my file correctly. Now I'm going to show you some special cases in the scoring service. First, sometimes short forms use screening items. One of these measures is the PROMIS Alcohol Use 7A short form. This short form starts by asking if you've had an alcoholic drink in the past 30 days. If you report that you haven't had a drink, you stop answering questions and no score is produced. When constructing an input file for this short form, I've included the alcohol screener item. You can see that 2 respondents in assessment 2, 1001 and 1002, reported not having a drink and therefore were done with the short form after that single item. I went ahead and uploaded this file for scoring. In the scored log file, all of the items were confirmed as belonging to the short form, but the screener item was not used to calculate a score. This is correct. In the scored output file, the highest scored count value is 7 because that screener item isn't being scored. You'll also notice that pin 1001 and 1002 are not here for time 2. This is when they reported not having a drink in the past 30 days and don't have a score. A second special case is an item that has a response option that's equivalent to not applicable. This response option is not used when calculating a score. There are a number of these responses in PROMIS sexual function and satisfaction measures. Here are examples from PROMIS version 1 global satisfaction with sex life item bank. The first 3 items here all have a response that is indicating the question is not applicable to that respondent. For example, have not had a partner in the past 30 days and have not had sexual activity in the past 30 days. These are equivalent to not applicable. Depending on the measure and where you got a copy of the measure, not applicable responses can appear as a score of 0 or 99 when all other responses are scored 1 to 5. It can look like a long string of zeros or as a text response like NA. In the data file, not applicable response options should be left blank. This is an example for the PROMIS Global Satisfaction with Sex Life measure. The first 2 respondents used have not had a partner in the past 30 days and have not had sexual activity in the past 30 days responses for the 3 questions we saw earlier. Therefore, these are left blank. The scored file produced by the scoring service shows only 4 of 7 items were used to calculate scores for these 2 respondents, which is correct. If I'd entered zeros, 99, or text instead of leaving those cells blank, a score would not be produced at all for that respondent. In this export, although I included data for all 9 of my respondents, I only have scores for 7, indicating I entered data incorrectly. The third special case are items with collapsed categories. This is another way of saying that 2 response options have the same score. It may look like an error on a PDF, but it's actually intentional. This is an example of one short form with collapsed categories, the PROMIS Pediatric Upper Extremity Short Form 8A. The items in this short form are scored 1 to 5. However, you can see that the first item only has scores from 1 to 4. This is because a response of with a lot of trouble and not able to do should be treated the same in score calculations. The raw data file should utilize the scores shown on the official measure PDF. If you entered a measure like this into a data collection software manually, you may not have used the same response scores as seen in the PDF version of the measure. So I encourage you to download the official PDF from the Search and View tool on healthmeasures.net. Finally, sometimes a measure is retired and replaced with a new version. For example, a number of PROMIS pediatric and parent proxy version 1 measures were replaced by version 2 measures. Fortunately, the scoring service includes retired measures. Here you can see both version 1 and version 2 pediatric fatigue measures are included in the scoring service. If you'd like to know how a measure changed between versions, for PROMIS, review the scoring manuals. You can find those in the Health Measures website under Calculate Scores. Here you see a comparison between the version 1 and version 2 adult PROMIS profiles. This concludes this tutorial on the scoring service. I encourage you to explore the healthmeasures.net website for information on interpreting scores, the development and validation of PROMIS, Neuro-QoL, Ask Me, and NIH Toolbox measures, and educational material, including screencasts on item response theory. If you have questions, contact us at help@healthmeasures.net. Thank you.